Hey everyone, it's Thomas and this is day 41 of 100 Days of Code in IoT Challenge. Today I'm gonna continue working on an automatic plant watering system and today's focus is going to be on the soil moisture sensor so I can read the percentage of the water in the soil of this plant. Okay, here again we have all the parts and components that we're gonna need to finish this circuit, the watering system. As you can see here, we've got already assembled circuit from yesterday. This is the peristaltic pump controlled by ESP8266, right? We've got the transistor and connected to the digital pin through the resistor and the peristaltic pump. What's changed is these three small wires in here connected to the ground. This is basically to improve the visibility on the diodes that I'm gonna connect to them that are going to indicate the state of the soil, right? So the moisture sensor that I'm gonna connect in a minute is going to feed the ESP8266 with the data about the soil, and based on that information, we're going to light up one of these diodes. The additional resistor that I've got is for the red diode, and this is because the red diode is rated lower than 3.3 volts, which is the voltage at the digital pin, and we have to drop it. So that's why I've got it here. The resistor is rated for 75 ohms, and you should see just now on the screen how have I come up with that value. I use the formula that needs a forward voltage of the diode, which is 1.8 volts. And its current, which is 20 milliamps. And with the voltage at the digital pin, I was able to calculate the resistance that needs to be used with this diode. Cool, okay. Some additional wires, and this is for the power supply, right? AC adapter set to 12 volts, and a sensor, which is the main subject of today's video, right? Okay. So now let's start assembling it, right? I'm gonna put the pump aside for now. The AC adapter is gonna be connected to the fuse on one side. On the other side, it's gonna go to the adapter plug, but I'm gonna do it at the end. And let's start from the moisture sensor, okay? So the moisture sensor fortunately operates on the same voltage as ESP8266 does. So what we can do is to connect the plus, which is here, right? Not sure how visible it is. It says VCC. And then ground is gonna go to the ground of the ESP8266. The last pin here, the bottom one, right? So we've got the ground, the black one. VCC is the red one. And we have analog out for the yellow one, right? And because this is an analog output, we're gonna have to connect it to an analog pin on ESP8266 instead of digital pin. There is one, it's called A0, and I'm gonna connect everything, wire everything up right now. So let's start from the power supply. Maybe we're gonna go for the white wire for the plus. And that is gonna go to 3V3 on the microcontroller. And now the blue one, that is gonna go to the ground. However, as we're going to have all the diodes connected to the ground as well, let's use this power rail on the breadboard. And now I'm just gonna connect the ground of ESP8266 to this power rail. Okay, so that's gonna be sorted. And finally, the yellow wire to the analog output on one side. And then here we have A0 there, right? It's this pin. So this is where the other end of the blue wire is gonna go to. Cool, okay, and now the diodes, this is gonna be pretty straightforward, so maybe I start from the red one, because this is the one that needs a resistor. Make sure the shorter leg is aligned with the gray wire. Okay. the resistor somewhere here and there. Okay, and from there I'm going to use the blue wire, and that's gonna go to, maybe let's go for D5. And two remaining diodes, that's gonna be pretty straightforward. Let's just quickly do it. Cool, yeah, that looks a little bit complicated, but let me go through the whole thing again, and then we're going to move to the code. So, starting from the peristaltic pump again, right, this is the 12 volt power source on this rails, okay, and from here, from the plus, we've got this red wire going to the peristaltic pump, and then the brown wire going from the peristaltic pump to the collector of the transistor, and from the emitter of the transistor, we've got this blue wire going to the ground. So that is how it is wired up with the transistor. And now, from the middle leg of the transistor, the base, the controlling part, we've got this resistor and the orange wire going to pin D1. This is from where ESP8266 controls the peristaltic pump. And now, on the moisture sensor, we've got it connected to 3V3 of ESP8266. And this is our white wire. Then the blue one is going to the minus rail of the breadboard, and this is where we are connected ESP8266 ground to, okay, using this black wire. And finally, these three diodes, which are connected all to the ground with the with these gray wires and with these three wires to the digital pins, D5, D6, D7. One exception for those is the red one, which needs a resistor to drop the voltage down. Okay, right. So now I can move to the code. However, there is one additional thing that we're gonna need, because since the moisture sensor uses the analog output, we're going to get the range of values depending on the amount of water in the soil. And for that, I'm gonna have to calibrate it, right? Because since this is a range, we need to know what is the minimum value and what is the maximum value, right? So now, before I connect it, let me grab the glass of water that I'm gonna put somewhere here. And I'm going to check the sensor with the water and without the water. But we're gonna try without the water to see what is the moisture in the air, okay? So we know the lowest value. And then I'm gonna put it into the water, so we will get the highest value. And based on that, we will be able to calculate the percentage of the water in the soil once I put it into the plant. Cool, okay, so yeah, let's move to the code and start capturing the value from the moisture sensor so we can find out what is the value for the air. Okay, so what I've got opened here is Visual Studio Code with the plant watering system project. The code is quite simple so far. As you can see, what we have here is the serial monitor configuration, right? The monitor speed is set to 115,200. This is from the platform io.ini configuration that needs to be the same here. We have the delay of 2 seconds for the IDE to catch up with the serial monitor, with the serial communication on the device. Then we're setting the pin mode D1, that is a controlling pin that controls the peristaltic pump through the transistor that acts as a switch, right? We set it to the output mode. And in here, we're just switching between high and low, right? So you probably remember from yesterday, the pump was like, you know, starting and stopping every second. And that was the code doing that, right? This code just, you know, did that. If you haven't watched that video, I really recommend to do, so you can catch up with everything I'm doing today. Cool, right? But the thing is, it's not the pump that we are interested in today, but the analog pin, right? The analog output from the moisture sensor. And for that, I'm gonna ignore D1 for now. I'm gonna keep it at the output mode. However, yeah, maybe just to be on the safe side, let's set it with digital write to low, so we know the pump is gonna stay off for now. And now, what we would like to determine again is the readings, the minimum reading on the analog pin from the moisture sensor and the maximum one, right? The minimum one can be obtained right now from the air, right? And how to do it? Very simple. I'm just going to use the printf function, printf method on the serial. And let's say I'm just going to type in moisture sensor reading. And that is going to be int. This is int. And how do I know it's int? I'm going to show you. So now what's going to be swapped with this %d, which represents the number, is going to be the result of the analog read function, right? It's like with digital write, digital read, you can also do analog read on the pin A0. There is only A0 on ESP8266. So this is the one that we're going to pass in here. And as you can see, actually it doesn't show anymore, but IDE shows us here, right? It's int. The result of analog read is int. Cool. Okay. And maybe I put some delay, like for 500 milliseconds, so we won't get too much data. Nice. Okay. So now with that code, I can deploy it and see what the readings are for the air. Okay, I'm connected to the serial monitor, and what we're getting is 846, right? 846. I'm gonna put it as a comment in here. So 846. That seems like a minimum one. Yeah, that doesn't change really. So yeah, okay, so that's the minimum one. And now let me put the sensor into the water, so we should get the maximum value. So I've got the glass of water here, and I'm just gonna put the sensor inside. Seems like the value is dropping actually. I'm really sorry, I thought it's gonna be other way around, right? So for the air, we get the higher value. And for the water, we get lower value. That's something to bear in mind. It looks like the minimum value is around 445, 446, something like that. I'm gonna put 442. And now let's calculate the percentage based on these values. And for that, we can actually use a function that is built in Arduino, and it's called map. Let me show you. So here you've got this. It takes how many arguments? We've got, yeah, here. So value from low, from high, to low, to high. Okay. And essentially how we can do it is, let me show you. So I think, yeah, what you need to pass is, let me just show you. From low and from high is gonna be the values, the minimum and maximum value of our analog pin. And too low and too high is going to be 0 and 100, I guess. Or maybe 1 and 100, because there is not really gonna be, it's not really possible to have a zero, I think, on the humidity, on the moisture, right? Cool, okay, so let's do it. So I'm going to modify that, and let's assign this analog read result to a variable, and let's call it moisture, or maybe analog val, maybe analog moisture value, right? So it has a meaningful name. And here what we're gonna do is to do map, where we're going to pass 442 as a minimum. So maybe let's define them as a constants, okay? So we will have two defines. One is gonna be analog moisture, but it needs to be like that. Analog moisture minimum and maximum. And that is gonna be 442. Maybe just let's pick a little slightly lower value, 440 and 840, 850 maybe as the maximum one. Right, remember to do this calibration yourself, because these values might depend also on the voltage that you supply to the sensor, right? So it might be different on Arduino, for example, where you operate on the 5 volts. Okay, so we've got that, and now let's try this map out. So we will have x in min in max, so that is gonna be, I'm not sure, okay, so x is our analog moisture value. Then we're going to put the analog moisture min, analog moisture max, and then 0, maybe let's go for 0 and 100. Or maybe, I'm not sure if 0 is the best one, so maybe let's do 1. Right, okay, so yeah, let's do 1, just to be on the safe side. It should be fine anyway, right? We don't have to be very exact with this. Great, okay, so let's try to deploy it and let's see what we get. Okay, there is one warning. That is true, because it is a long now, so it shouldn't be D. So I'm gonna redeploy it. Okay, so we're getting 1. Oh, that's probably need to be other way around, isn't it? Because the sensor is still in the water, and we get 1. So yeah, I need to swap these values. I'm not sure if this is really possible. Let me try it out. We try again, and I try to remove it from the water. So we'll see if it changes in the air. Okay, we're getting 100, and let me remove it from the water. Okay, that value changed immediately, so it's quite reactive, right? Now we have 2. Okay, putting into water again. And 98 straight away, okay. Cool, yeah, so this is fine. And now, before I put it into the plant, let me implement the diode's behavior, okay? The diode's behavior. So, just a reminder for you. And maybe I define them as a constant, so we know what are the colors. So we have red, blue, and green. And these are D5, D6, and D7. Right, these are LEDs, so let's just do something like that, LED and LED, right? So there's gonna be D5, D6, and D7. And now let's define the range of values for which the different diodes should light up, right? For now, I'm just gonna have it hard-coded, but ultimately what we want to do is for the program to determine itself, or even better, maybe to make it possible to do it in the app, on the internet, right? Some in the cloud location, and then device could pick it up and water the plant depending on those values, okay? But yeah, for now, what I'm going to do is maybe let's say what is the optimum level, right? What is the range for the optimum level? And then if it drops below that level or above that level, we're going to light up a different diodes. Let's do it now. Okay, so let's define this range. Let's call it maybe the optimal mean. Let's put this value as 50 for now. I'm not actually sure what is the right one for this particular plant, But I'm gonna make it possible to configure it from the internet. So that should make it easier. So yeah, optimal max, and that's gonna be, let's say this is 60. So let's say our sweet spot is between 50 and 60. Right, and now inside the loop, first of all, we would like to keep reading that value, but also assigning it to something, right? And let's see if we can do a cast into an int, because that really returns the long. It returns long, but I would like to get an int instead. Oh, hang on. Let's see. Let's call it moisture val, and that will be this. Okay, so we've got it done, and I'm here in the serial printf. We still want to display that value, but because I've already cast it, I'm not sure if this can be done implicitly though. Let's see what compiler is gonna say. So that will be D now. We don't need to use LD flag anymore. So yeah, we will get that, and here I'm just gonna use a simple if statement, right? Simple if statement, and what we want to do is do something like if moisture value is below the optimal minimum, then we're gonna do something, and if moisture value is greater than optimal max, then you're gonna do something else, and this is gonna be switching on or switching off the diodes, right? Changing the values on the digital pin, the voltage on the digital pins. But for that, I need to set all the pin modes, all of them, to mode output. So we'll have pin mode, and what do we have? We have red LED, and that is gonna be output. And the rest. Okay, another useful thing, a reset function. So that will allow us to reset all the LEDs, okay? So yeah, maybe let's do it this way. So we will have something like that. Something like that, just for the sake of simplicity. We're gonna go with this, and that's gonna be low, and low. Right, so we always do the reset if we have any change. Okay, so that's what happens. And I'm just thinking, ideally we would have something like that, right? So that would be if, and else. Also starts with the maybe the reset is just one thing in here. We don't really need a function, but yeah, it's gonna improve the readability of the code. And here, digital write, and that is gonna be. So if the moisture value is below the optimal minimum, we are interested in the red color, right? So we're gonna do red LED high, right? So that should switch on. If it's other way around, it's too much moisture in the soil, we want to do blue one. And the other one, which is the optimum value, and that is gonna be the green. Great. Okay, so that is done. With the delay at the end, let's keep the delay. So there's gonna be always a half second break, a pause, right? And yeah, so that should be it. Let's see how it looks like right now. Okay, cool. So now we can see the blue diode, right? And this is because the moisture sensor is inside the water. Let me remove it from the glass. And what happened, right? Immediately, it changed to the green one that looks more yellowish, but it's really green. And after that to red, because we are below the optimum value, which is 37. Okay, and now let's test it with the real plant. So I'm just gonna put the sensor inside the soil of the plant, and let's see what the readings, what is gonna be the reading that we get. At the moment is 2, 4, 3, something like that. and let me put it inside. Okay, it is inside now. And that seems like it has too much water at the moment. I'm not sure what is the optimum value though, so that's something I have to check for this particular species. But yeah, for the range that I set myself, it is a little bit too high because we're getting 76. Okay, so now let me sum everything up. What we've got on one hand is a peristaltic pump controlled from the digital pin on ESP8266 through the transistor acting as a switch. On the other hand, we have a soil moisture sensor that we can read the values from, and depending on that value, we can switch on or switch off different diodes to indicate the status of the soil of the plant. Right? What's left is to bring it everything together so we can have a nice watering system that water the plant depending on the value from the sensor. But that's something I'm going to finish up tomorrow. For today, this is it. Thanks for watching. If you find this content useful, you like it, don't forget to subscribe. I also suggest hitting this bell button, right? So you will definitely get a notification when I upload the next video. And yeah, thanks again and see you tomorrow.